My worst part, I hate to rag on Mila Kunis again, but at the end, you know, her overall performance, it was just a case of miscasting. Yep. And at the end, there's a shot that echoes a few shots from earlier in the movie of Denzel, and no.
Yeah.
Not a fan of that.
Yeah, my worst part is the exact same thing you're talking about. I pretty much tolerated her for most of the movie because it's Mila Kunis, and they could get her, so they got her. But my quiet, displeasure mm-hmm. was vocal displeasure
right.
during the final shot of the movie, or one of the final shots where, we'll get to that when we get into our spoilers. And then my best part is the final 10 minutes of the movie. Again, we'll get to that in a minute for our spoilerific part of the review. But that last 10 minutes is absolutely beautiful. And it's not too often that I pop in an actioner and I leave it feeling really fulfilled and, mm-hmm. and like just warm and gooey inside. So hats off to everybody who made The Book of Eli. So now let's spoil this thing.
So if you are going to see The Book of Eli and haven't seen it, turn it off now. Thanks for watching.
Turn off the review.
And if not, here we go.
Yeah.
So when I saw this movie in the theater, I was with it up until the reveal of the book being Braille and that Eli was supposed to have been blind the whole time.
And when I saw that, I was like, what?
I thought, okay, there was a few moments where he mentioned smell, so I bought that.
Yeah.
But there are other scenes where Denzel is running in the street, shooting people on rooftops and stuff. And I was like, I was calling bullshit.
Yeah.
But then rewatching the movie now, they really have thought it through right from the beginning in Denzel's performance. You can actually see him feeling a lot of things, bumping into stuff. The sense of smell is really prevalent. And every time that he like shoots a bad guy in that one action scene, every one of them has either made a sound or fired a shot first. And because he has such acute hearing, because he is blind, he goes right to that spot.
Which is a great way to handle it instead of saying divine influence.
Right.
Which is, I guess, in the context of this movie, would be okay.
It could.
But for the skeptic, it's even nicer to have like an actual scientific explanation for why he's able to shoot these guys.
And sure, maybe divine influence made it so that he didn't miss anyone.
Yeah.
but the Hughes brothers did their homework and everything is there on the screen, and Denzel should be commended because his performance, when you watch it back, is really well done. And even the dialogue, there are lots of foreshadowing and stuff that if you know where the movie's going, when you get there, it's like even more satisfying because they didn't trick you. It wasn't an M. Night moment where they undo everything that went before. This isn't The Village, so like it does work.
Thank God. Book being Braille was really amazing, him being blind, and him reciting the Bible at the end to the Alcatraz Press guy. Just amazing. Like the fact that he's memorized the entire Bible.
Yeah.
And that Gary Oldman stuck with a Braille Bible. And it's just a really good, fulfilling ending where the bad guy, you know, gets what he deserves. And it's not just him being blown up.
Right.
Like that's a really torturous thing that he is going to have to endure
you know,
with his rotting leg and dying slowly and not getting this book he's always wanted. And that Mila Kunis shot that we both mentioned in our worst part, after Eli has passed away, Mila Kunis is going to go and she's going to, I guess, get her revenge. So she pops on the Eli sunglasses and she's got the Eli blade.
The iPod.
And she's going to go and she's going to kick some butt. And that was the only time I actually had to go, oh, come on. It's Mila Kunis.
Yeah.
It's not Charlize Theron. It's Mila Kunis. And don't ruin my perfect ending.
Right. And I don't know if it was meant to be sort of a bit of a downer moment, but I was very surprised that at the end, after he recites the Bible and they print up the Bible, I thought it was with the intention of they were going to like print massive copies and like it was going to be this big deal. And they actually just shelve it beside the Quran, the history of the Jewish faith, and all sorts of other stuff. So it's like, okay, he got the Bible out there, but now it might actually just sit on this library shelf for years and years to come, and it actually isn't going to possibly influence people in the future. They left it really ambiguous whether that contribution is going to make a difference or not. So it's up to the viewer.
Yeah, exactly. It's open to interpretation. You know, I kind of got the feeling that they were going to mass produce it, and that was just like the first precious edition.
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah, it's nice to not be told everything to a T,
right,
what's going on. Yeah, great movie. Wow, really surprising.
Yeah, so if you haven't seen it and you like Denzel or post-apocalyptic movies, go out and see it. I'm sure you won't be disappointed.
Yeah. And we're on Twitter. You can follow us on Twitter. We're at Armchair Guys. At Armchair Guys. Is that how Twitter works?
www.twitter.com/armchairguys.
Shows you how often I'm on Twitter.
You're a tweet master, apparently. Yes. All right. So until next time.
Thanks for watching and enjoy the show. And you should know what do. Well, it's been about 3 years since I first met your face. Yeah. Well, I'm talking about people getting sad.